Puska!
So many chances to live. Now your only option is to die.
Duck!
No, I'm a cat! Oh, but I think I see what you're getting at.
Alright, take three. Hey guys, and welcome to the final boss of Pitfall, the Lost Expedition. Now you may be wondering why I put this part out before, Splinter Cell Conviction. Well, that's simply because I figured you guys would be looking forward to the end of Splinter Cell Conviction more than Pitfall, and I figured I'd end on a high note rather than a low note. Alright, so, the final boss is fairly simple. It's essentially, Puska is up there, flying in the air, and you have to knock these pillars into him using the glowing power that Neela gave to you, via the Demon Jaguar boss fight. Now I am gonna say this after I explain this attack right here. First round, Puska's just gonna be throwing fireballs at you. Once you hit him, he's going to jump around the arena a certain number of times. I think this time it was three or four. And then he'll have a bunch of palette swap versions of himself running around on the ground. This number will go up by one every time, so that means by the final hit, you're going to have at least six of these things running around on the ground. Now, bear in mind that there are never more than what he puts out. He doesn't actually continuously spawn them. It's just, at the beginning, there's four, and they will just throw his little fireball attack. You'll just have to be looking from different directions. Once you have one hit on him, which I actually have... Once you have one hit on him, he'll change up his basic fireball attack, which you all witnessed earlier, to this kind of homing electric thing, which is honestly really annoying to dodge. As you see, it's already taken off half my health. This is one of the reasons why I would suggest going into the boss fight with full health rather than the minus a couple units, so that way you can just last a little bit longer. But on the second hit, he'll summon five of these things, and I don't actually remember what I was talking about earlier, so I'm just gonna forget it. I do think they could have done a little bit better with this boss fight, because the physics behind the pillars are a little floaty, to be completely honest. They'll tend to go wherever they want to go rather than wherever you have hit them to, and they'll sometimes get stacked up as shown right here, and you can't actually hit them when they're in the air. As far as I know, I could be completely 100% wrong about this. Alright, he's got two more hits left, and okay, make that one. That was kind of a lucky shot. So now he's gonna summon six of his little palette swaps. One, two, three, four, five, six. I also want to mention that these things, I think, appear to get faster, though I may be wrong about that. I don't think I had to dash to any of the previous ones, but I could be wrong. They are fairly annoying to track down, and you probably will end this fight with one hit just because of these guys, but just abuse the crap out of your canteen when you're down to one of these things, or go into the little side areas where you can avoid most of Puska's attacks, and you should be fine. But yeah, this isn't the greatest final boss in the world, but it works for what it's trying to do. And no, I'm not really sure what... Oh! Okay, apparently this is his final last-ditch attack. He'll attempt to light you on fire via pouring lava.
Oh! Gunchars!
Thank you.
Thank you. Though I'm a princess, I've never met a prince. Until now. Mwah.
Hey, don't forget the cat!
What? The prophecies didn't say anything about a cat.
Well, you can't go believing every prophecy you hear.
I guess this is our life now. We'll never see our own time again.
Any regrets?
2. I never got to apologize to Dr. Crane for treating him so poorly. That, and I couldn't save.
What happened?
It's a long story.
You know, there might be a lot of fish in the sea, but you got a good one.
You can talk, you little liar.
On the other hand, maybe you shouldn't rule out the other fish.
So, what happens to you now?
You heard me, Kay. I've been cursed. I don't fit into the world of man or animal. Hey, you're ever back this way? Look me up.
How will I find you?
Just get in trouble. I'll be there to save you. Just like I did this time. Unbelievable. Even with 500 years between us. She still finds a way to torment me. Figures she... Even after I...
So, what next?
There's this man back home, Dr. David Crane, who I owe a long overdue visit. And there are some remote areas of Africa I want to check out. Roots of mankind.
You need to do all that today?
What do you have in mind?
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, that's it for pretty much all of the gameplay, but we're not quite done yet. Now that we have beaten Pitfall Harry, we still have a little bit of collecting to do, though I will not be showing that off. This is pretty much a note telling you that, hey, whoa, you're not completely done with the game, even though you've saved the girl. Yeah, I've never been one to say that. Alright! Now you can play as Nicole by inputting this code onto the main menu. So I think I'll go ahead and be showing that off fairly soon, as well as another code that we picked up a little earlier. There are three skins for Harry. There is this basic skin that you have. I think you can also play as Harry's Arctic gear, but I'm just gonna cut to the main menu real fast. Alright, there are a couple of codes that you can input on the front of the screen, and I'll probably be going over all of those. Never. But the one we are going to be looking for right now is by holding L and R and pressing left, up, down, up, X, up, up, you can play as the stunning and darling Nicole. Ta-da! Weirdly enough, she has all of Harry's voice clips. They didn't bother to try and effeminate any of them, so she'll continue to sound like Harry throughout the entirety of the game. There's other codes that you can input, like Canteen Always Full, play the classic Pitfall game from the main menu, Global Slow Motion, which I'm not actually sure what that one is, to be completely honest, play Pitfall II, The Lost Caverns, from, it will now be selectable from the new game and load screen menus, which is weird if you ask me, but whatever. But now we're going to be looking at, the next code on here, which is play as Retro Harry. Hold L and R and press Y left, down B, X, Y left. Once you have done this, you should hear a tone of some kind to ensure that you have inputted the code correctly. By the way, if you're wondering about that 100% that it says on that load file right there, that's how much of the story I have done. Just figured I'd clear that up real fast. And this is Retro Harry. Now you may be wondering what he looks like. Yep, that's right. That dude from the Atari Pitfall game. You can play as him. And it's a little weird seeing all this. By the way, all the items are still rendered in 3D, which is weird, but whatever. Alright, there is one more code that allows you to get super punches, but I won't be discussing that, to be completely honest, because I find that is overpowered, as well as the canteen one. So, that's really all that I have to show off for Pitfall, unless you guys really want me to do a 100% collectible run through of this, which I probably won't be doing even if you ask me. So yeah, that's not happening. I am ShadeGrey, and I hope you all enjoyed this playthrough.